Life in the watery world of marine mammals like sea otters, seals, and whales is very different from that of terrestrial animals like us. That means their tools and senses have to be different as well.
There is plenty of evidence that animals have senses other than the traditional sight, smell, taste, touch, and hearing. So today, we're going to count down the top five wildest six senses in the animal kingdom. Number five, electroreception. All living creatures produce electromagnetic fields. These electrical charges are emitted when the animals contract their muscles. And some animals, particularly sharks and rays, have the ability to detect these minute electromagnetic fields. Thanks to their saltwater habitat, which acts as a strong conductor of electricity, sharks can detect their prey through sensory receptors called the ampullae of Lorenzini. The ampullae are mostly clustered into groups, and the specific clusters of these groups depends largely on the individual species. For example, the ampullae of a hammerhead shark are densely clustered across the broad surface of its head. By distributing the receptors over a wider area, hammerheads can sweep for their prey more effectively, giving them the most sensitive electroreception in the world. Have you ever built up static electricity by rubbing your socks on the carpet or a balloon against your hair? Well, a hammerhead shark would be able to detect that tiny electrical field from about 8 miles away. Number four, echolocation. All toothed whales, like dolphins or beluga whales, have the ability to do echolocation, which is sometimes referred to as biosonar. Just like a submarine, these whales and dolphins can produce clicks and whistles and then listen back for the echoes of those clicks. They use these echoes to navigate, measure distances, and even detect objects. This allows them to explore their environment in three dimensions. They generate these clicks by passing them through an organ in their blowhole called the phonic lips. The sounds are then focused through a fatty organ on the front of their heads called a melon. If you watch closely, you can see this beluga whale can actually change the shape of its melon. What that does is change the focus of the sound wave, similar to how the lens of a flashlight can narrow or widen a beam of light. A cetacean's echolocation works similarly to an ultrasound. When a dolphin echolocates on a human, they are able to see muscle tissue, bone tissue, scar tissue, even metal pins and rods. They can even tell when someone is pregnant. Now, I've been working with these animals for many, many years, and that still is surprising and a little gross to me. Number three, magnetoreception. It is a proven fact that sea turtles can sense the Earth's magnetic field. As hatchlings, turtles that have never been in the ocean before can use this sixth sense to follow complex migratory pathways across entire ocean basins. Scientists use satellite telemetry to discover that individual turtles unerringly follow specific migratory routes using both a bio-coordinate magnetic map and a magnetic compass. Then, once they are about 25 to 40 years old and sexually mature, they return to a specific beach to mate and nest. But it's not always the exact same beach. The nesting sites of sea turtles shift in relation to the corresponding shifts of the Earth's magnetic field. But how? Where does this magnetoreception come from? Well, this is where things get weird, because scientists don't actually know. Unlike the five traditional senses, like sight and taste, that rely on sensory organs like our eyes and tongue, there is no sensory organ responsible for magnetoreception. One hypothesis suggests that turtles possess a magnetically sensitive protein called a cryptochrome. Another hypothesis put forward is that the sense comes from clusters of iron found in the turtle's beak. The most recent proposal, however, might just be the weirdest yet. And it is that sea turtles sense magnetic fields through a symbiotic relationship with a bacteria that is sensitive to those fields. And scientists are taking this proposal very seriously because the DNA from those bacteria is found in sea turtles and homing pigeons. Number two, Ropalia. Few creatures in this world are stranger or more alien than the gelatinous jellyfish. Can there be a jellyfish right here? Most jellies do not have specialized systems for respiration or circulation. In fact, most don't even have a central nervous system. Yet they are able to balance and orient themselves in the water. They clearly don't have eyes, and yet they do respond to changes in light and color. They are even able to detect prey and move their arms in order to reel in that prey. Instead of sensory organs and a central nervous system, jellyfish rely on a specialized network of nerves that enables them to detect changes in the chemical structure of the ocean. They have little structures along the rim of the bell called ropalia. Each one is packed with microscopic crystals that help the jelly sense the direction of gravity, similar to our inner ear. They also have small pigment spots called ocelli that allow the eyeless animals to sense light and dark. It's almost like combining the eyes, ears, even the nose, maybe even the cerebellum, all in one place. Because jellyfish do have a flight or flight response, and they even display mating rituals. The ocean is a bizarre place. Number one, lateral lines. That's right, sharks don't just have a sixth sense, they follow it up with a seventh. This sense allows them to detect water speed changes and movement in the ocean around them. This tactile sensory system not only provides spatial awareness and the ability to navigate, but it helps the shark detect prey. They can actually tell the difference between the currents of the ocean and the hydraulic trail left behind by fish and seals. According to one hypothesis, this is the reason prey fish congregate in large schools. A single fish creates a rather simple hydraulic trail, very easy to follow. However, a school will leave trails that overlap and create a complex pattern that makes it difficult for sharks' lateral lines to identify individual fish. There you have it, the top five wildest sixth senses in the animal kingdom. What do you think? Did I get it right? Let me know in the comments below. And I'll see you next time. Cheers. This sense allows them to detect water speed changes and movement in the ocean around them. When a dolphin echolocates... In fact, most don't even have a central nervous system.